Okay guys, I'm catching all the games. We are back with J-Stace versus Pearl. Nice mono shiny team, looks disgusting. But yeah, for OUPL week 2. And the score should be in this series. Those are Easy's teammates. Easy lost versus Steve, I uploaded earlier. Ricardo will still play, so the score is 2-2 at the moment. Between the NJMP Ninjas, I think. They are managed by Zomok and Bengay, and yeah, they're playing versus the versus Andy's team. I forgot who the second manager is. But yeah, Jay Stasis on the Bengay Zomok team. That's my man Padlob's team. I brought some Mimikyu offense. That could be a hazard stack, like lead Skarmory with spikes and rocks. I've even seen Supersonic Skystrike lead Skarmory, which is interesting. And yeah, on the other side, we have some balance. Let me see. Probably rocks for Fable, yeah. It's the only potential rocker anyway, so it has to be rocks. Unless my dude Pearl is like, nah, I'm not using stealth rocks. That's for tryhards, just kidding. Yeah, so I have the Slowbro to check the Medichamp, but Electric Terrain Thunder Punch will blow that away too. So you probably have to try to pivot around that. Like probably have to try to go Zygarde on a T-Punch or go Slowbro on an Ice Punch. I guess to predict correct around the Medichamp when that thing comes in on something like Celeste Dealer. Or on something that on Bulu maybe too. If Bulu is not at full, Ice Punch will probably kill that. Or then have but even. But yeah, he leads with a Hazard Scum, I assume, because Pearl doesn't have Hazard Control, besides Lari, but yeah, I guess he has a Lari, yeah. But I was thinking it's probably Scarf Lari. He has a Volcarona, which also checks Zygarde, if it... I mean, I meant it the other way around, my brain and my head, like, I mixed it up. He has a Zygarde, which checks Volcarona, not a Volcarona, which checks Zygarde with God. So it doesn't have to be Scarf Lari is what I'm trying to say. But speed control is always nice, and I guess it could be like T-Wave Clef or T-Wave Slower for speed control, but I'm pretty sure the Scarf Lari, like that always makes sense. Okay, so if that's bulky Skarmory, which it's not left over, so I'm not sure if it's gonna be bulky. I mean, it could still be Shed Shell, but yeah, I assume that was bulky Skarmory, because that was probably Bandit Zygarde, yeah. And the only reason it only did 1500 first, because Skarmory got smacked down then. Like, 1000 arrows is not super effective on Skarmory the first time it hits it. But yeah, Medicham is in, threatens the Zygarde out with an Ice Punch, and I don't know if Slower will get to it go from Thunder Punch if there is no Electric Terrain. Yeah, you can probably go to Clefable here. Because there's no electric terrain up, so if it's like Bolt Clef, it should avoid a Tweet KO. Unless this is Poison Jab, Medicham. But yeah, I assume we're gonna see. Ooh, my lord, nice double into Greninja. So this covers, depending on the Greninja set, this potentially covers the Clefable and the Slowbro. Because, like, he doesn't know the Greninja set. Like, even if he went Clef there, he doesn't know if this is Ash or Protein. That's one of the reasons why Greninja is so good, you don't know what it is literally. Like, it can do everything, potentially. Has all the tools, and he can go for spikes if he has that. But yeah, he goes for Palm, that looks to be spikes. Ashgren. Battle Bond, I mean. And yeah, he can go into Bulu or Slowbro or Lari here. So he made a nice prediction there, predicting Pearl to scout for Dark Pulse, he went for Hydro Pump, and I assume he's gonna double out on the Lari or on the Slowbro on the Bulu, something like that. But he just attacks again, gets damage off, that works. So the Lari can go for Defog here if it has that. I think he's gonna go Coco here, or... He doesn't have good Lari switch-ins, but yeah, he goes Coco. On a defog and probably gonna U-turn here. Slash HP Ice. Probably U-turn, yeah. Like, he goes Bulo or Zygarde here, I think. He can also sack the Clef if he doesn't want to risk Zygarde and HP Eyes. Yeah, he sacks the Clef. Like, that's just madness into T-Bolt kills. I mean, he's still, he can still save it now and predict the T-Bolt, but it's a bit risky. But he does that, predicts the T-Bolt, goes Zygarde. Okay, that worked out. Yeah, I think that was pretty free there. He didn't want to let the Clef heal. So Pearl predicted a T-Bolt or a taunt. No, obviously you would T-Bolt there, you wouldn't taunt, because the Clef is in range to dive on T-Bolt, yeah. So if this bandit, he has to go Landorus, I think. Or he has to sack something. Landorus is the only thing that can take a hit. It's basically what I'm trying to say. As that still did so much, I don't even know if that's max defense Lando. Max defense Lando takes like 33, I think, or 31, so that's like... I don't know if it's like a complete offensive Lando, or if it has a little bit of HP investment, or defense. But yeah, it's an offensive Lando. Probably Z-move on this team, unless it's Z-move Mimikyu. Yeah, on Pearl's team, I assume it's Z-move Tapu Bulu with probably Swords Dance. But yeah, look at Proteam Greninja with the correct coverage, and look at this team. Like, Proteam Greninja is just broken. Like, Gangshot the Clef, Gangshot this, or Ice Beam, whatever you wanna say. Slowbro probably walls it because they didn't run Dark Pulse at the moment. But yeah, Ice Beam for Zygarde. And the HP Fire still hits Steeler decently hard. Yeah, I think Dark Pulse is pretty rare on Slowbro, but then again, yeah, he sacks off the Clef there. On the turns that you switch around Protein Gren and... or try to figure out the set, they get up Spikes, which is like huge. So gets into Bulu. JCS doesn't have good answers. Switch in the wise especially. So maybe is he Scarf Landorus because he went for Earthquake again? That's a free substitute for Pearl. It's funny how SmackDown Landorus got SmackDowned and got Grassy Terrain Recovery. I don't know if he Scarf or way Earthquake again. I mean, yeah, his team is kind of slow, but he has priority in Faker, Shadow Sneak, and he has Disguise to check stuff, Water Shuriken on Greninja probably. So I don't know if he needs a Scarfer, but the way he off-fleed again makes me think that he's Scarf. Because otherwise, I guess he just wanted to sack this, and this being sub-SD is really bad for Jace Days. Oh my lord. This Bulu might just win. So this next Earthquake might break the sub, so I think Pearl will potentially go for sub again here, but... See the Coco come out. Yeah, he went for sub again, predicting Earthquake. Probably would have broken the sub, yeah. That makes a lot of sense. And this is gonna go... The Coco is gonna go for something that can break the sub. U-turn T-Bolt. Like, everything can basically break the sub. Because the sub already took two Earthquakes, if I recall correctly. Yeah. So, like, U-turn HPS, everything's gonna break it. And, like, he's gonna go Lander, I assume. But if he subs again here... Okay, he only just... Gets a lot of health back. And that Landorus living on 1% is pretty bad for Jace Days. Because this gives the Bulu another substitute. Good lord, this Bulu is scary. If you don't have... Like, he doesn't have a Scizor on his team. Like, his Skarmory already died. If he had the Skarm, I guess he could have an answer. But yeah, HPS breaks the sub. So at least this doesn't get a free sub, which is nice. So yeah, I assume there's a Scarf Landorus. Still not 100% sure. So like his way of checking for Corona is basically getting rocks up, putting in Water Shuriken range, and having Mimikyu's disguise intact, and priority to revenge it and fake it and yeah, Shuriken, like I said. Because Scarf Lando does not speed that at plus one, and I don't think he's Scarf Coco. But yeah. He can go Medicham or Greninja might kill it. Greninja with Ice Beam if it has Ice Beam. But I assume we're gonna see a Medicham or a Mimikyu come out here. Depending on if the Skarmory has Defog, the Greninja might be Spikes, might not be Spikes. Like if the Skarmory is Defog and he's like more... He only has Rocks, then Defog makes sense. But if you have Spikes too, Defog doesn't make that much sense, I feel. But yeah, okay, this makes me think that he's Ice Beam on Greninja. So I'll probably go Slowbro here, or... Slowbro or Celesteela here if I'm Pearl. Celesteela's a mid-ground play in case he makes an aggressive Dark Pulse play here. But it's not like Jace can play around with a plus one type of blue, it's a threat to his team, so I think he has to go for Ice Beam. Yeah, I'll just go Steela here. Actually, yeah, Steela was slower like I said, but Steela is a safer play. I guess a Spike would be an aggressive play, like aggressive as Flip, but if you run Ice Beam, you don't run Spikes. You run Hydro Pump, Dark Pulse, Water Shuriken on Ashgren, aka Battle Bond. And the last move is either Spikes, Ice Beam, or U-Turn. Which Spikes is so good at the moment, good lord. There's not really that much health control, besides the sack of the Lardy, and yeah, you see, in case he went the Dark Pulse play, that's where I would have gone Celesteela probably. If before Greninja gets its Ash form off, Dark Pulse doesn't do that much to Steela, depending on the set. Like if it's Bedevil, Steela can eat up pretty well, but maybe his booty doesn't have that much HP as I was expecting. I don't know why he switched out there. Like I don't know if that would have killed Greninja or you. Choice bags. Dark Pulse would have done 30 to 36. If the Tapu Bulu is running no bulk, so yeah, it wouldn't have killed the Bulu. So he just made an aggressive read there. I mean, Pearl just sacked the Lardy anyway. Because if anything, you go for Ice Beam there if you want to hit the Bulu that's in front of you. I don't think he lost much. If he Spedev Steela, Steela would have been fine, I think. But I don't know his set. And that can still get flinched down, so it's not like a best counter. But it's like a mid-ground, it covers Ice Beam, it covers Dark Pulse, you can see what the Greninja does. So Zygarde lifts the specs Dark Pulse, and if it can avoid a flinch, it basically gets a kill here. Pearl should win this, I think, besides Hacks. Tapu Bulu is still really nice because it gets a kill later on when it comes in on Tapu Koko, I think, yeah. Even if Mimikyu still has his disguise intact. Okay, he says to sack the Medicham, and that surprisingly lives the Bandit 1000 arrows at 2%. Is that a roll? So he can either go to Slowbro here, or... I don't think sacking Zygarde is the play. But yeah, that's 80 to 94. Oh, that's jolly. That's 87 to 103, so that was a roll. Okay, that's a nice play. J-Stays doubled out into Greninja, predicting the Slowbro. So yeah, J-Stays is in the back, he has to make plays now. That was well done. If Pearl stayed in there, the game would have been over, but yeah, this worked out. And yeah, now that this cut off the Ash form, this is a really big threat. Because like, Celesteela can't take these Dark Poses that well, even if it's Spedef. Sex of the Slowbro. And Tapu Bulu might even die to this after it gets off the Ash form. Okay, so he decides to go Zygarde. And now he's probably gonna sack off the Medicham. So J-State's played himself back into this game. I thought he lost. It's like one of these offensive teams where you kind of have to make plays at some point of the game when the opponent has a bulkier balance-ish team. Like, the opponent is just gonna say, like, I have the balance team, I'm gonna play safe most of the time, not every time. Okay, he says a sack of Coco instead of Medicham. And Medicham. Zagat runs Adamant on Band anyway, so yeah, Medicham should outspeed this for sure. Even if the Medicham itself runs Adamant. He's gonna suck off the Bulldog and probably Ice Punch here. Yep. So after the Slower was gone, Medicham pretty much got a kill every time it came in on the Bulldog. Medicham Kid gonna do 5 million to the Celesteeler. And yeah, Ash Greninja. You can click Dark Pulse here with Ash Grin. And then Zayat basically cannot lock itself into E-Speed. So it has to go for Thousand Arrows, and yeah, J-State wins, because Mimikyu still has the Disguise intact. I don't think this Celesteela can live this, even with the Spadef boost. Yeah, he had to get a double protect there. Doesn't get it, and Zagat, even if it lives one, is in range to die from a Shadow Claw. He doesn't have to risk a player of missing. His Greninja even lives that, good lord. Oh yeah, Passion is online, he's playing soon versus Tony. He said good job to Jay, that's his teammate. So yeah, he played that pretty well. Druid goes to Zygarde, and I hope you all enjoyed. We will have the other games coming up. This is all going up 1 or 2 days after the games happened, because my net decided to die on Sunday, my fast net. So I'm on my slow net that still allows me to use Pokemon Showdown and record for you guys, thankfully, but I cannot upload fast. Like, uploading one video takes like 10 or 12 hours. It's fucking ridiculous, like maybe even longer. Like, if I record a 50 minute video, I remember back in the day, like 4 or 5 months ago, I recorded some 50 minute videos and that took like 24 hours to go up. Like, that was crazy.